and thanks for watching Spoke TV,
your source for weekly news produced by second-year broadcast journalism students at Conestoga College. I'm Leah Johansson.
And I'm Jeff Pickle.
Jeff, this week's episode's all about winter.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We have a lot of winter in this week's show. We talk about snow plows, we talk about hockey safety, the flu season, and even dreaded holiday shopping. But first, we begin with keeping the roads safe. Drinking and driving incidents typically increase during the holiday season. Spoke TV's Joe Dyke tells us about the efforts of police to help keep impaired drivers off the streets.
With the arrival of seasonal celebrations, ride programs will be getting officers out onto the main roads to check for possibly intoxicated drivers. And with these Christmas parties and other festivities on the way, there will be a lot of red, white, and blue to follow. Olaf Heinzel of Waterloo Regional Police explains how these ride programs work.
Throughout the region, at any time of the day or night, on any day of the week, randomly, and it's essentially an area where officers will be set up and will be asking drivers to stop. And the officer will approach the driver and ask them if they've been drinking. And if they have been drinking, then certain steps will follow after that. If they have not been drinking and the officer is satisfied that the driver is sober and can continue to drive safely, the officer will then ask them to continue and proceed.
Lori Sesney explains how she's been affected by impaired driving.
Because my mom was hit by a drunk driver from behind, she was hospitalized for nearly a month with internal bleeding, and it made the family very scared. We worried about her a lot.
According to Mad Canada, vehicle crashes are the leading cause of death among 16 to 25-year-olds. 55% are alcohol and drug-related. The festive ride programs start November 29th and runs until the end of the year.
Ride programs are important because they keep an eye out for intoxicated drivers in order to keep the public safe by keeping them off the roads.
So remember, the next time you're out with friends, to take a taxi or have a designated driver and stay safe this Christmas season. For Spoke TV, I'm Joe Dyke.
After the heavy snowfall we received last year, the city has already spent its entire snow removal budget for this year. Spoke TV reporter Jay Clayfield has more on what area residents can expect the streets to look like this winter.
There's no way to avoid it. Winter is coming with a vengeance, and it is going to make driving a lot more hazardous. The cities of Waterloo, Kitchener, and Cambridge have already gone over their winter snow removal budget. The snow, however, isn't going to let up, and the cities are going to have to continue removing snow anyways. Kitchener is $900,000 over their allotted $5.3 million budget, and Cambridge and Waterloo each spent $25,000 and $100,000 respectively over budget. The heavy winter earlier this year depleted much of the budgets, and the cities have hired fewer contractors than usual. What can the city do to alleviate the pressure on snow removal teams? Plow driver Jamie Weissick of Moser Landscaping Groups gives us his look on things.
Well, it would be nice to see them lay out more sand to create more traction. It would create less salt use, and I feel a lot more sand would be better.
Despite the efforts of snow removal, remaining snow on the sidewalk and on the road continues to be a problem for pedestrians and drivers alike, as winter drivers face a variety of hazards.
Kitchener doesn't keep the roads cleared off enough. Like, you have to drive in the middle of both lanes because the sides aren't cleared off.
People driving too fast and not realizing that in the winter you need to slow down.
The roads get really slippery and everybody sucks at driving in the winter and my car slides all around.
Drivers are advised to drive defensively and to be aware of the road conditions and weather. For Spoke TV, I'm Jay Clayfield.
The region of Waterloo is used to getting glowing reviews about the quality of life in the area. But as Lauren Weiler tells us, a new report finds that this may not be the case. The study by Immigrant reveals that Kitchener is in the top five worst cities for immigrants to live.
Kitchener may have a high crime rate against people of different ethnicities, religions, and sexual orientation, but it isn't as high as it used to be. Immigroup.com dropped Kitchener down two spots from number 2 to number 4 on their list of worst places for immigrants to move. Some put a positive spin on the ranking and said it could just mean that more people were reporting crimes. Carmen Pontiano, a student at Conestoga College, shares some of the struggles she had when she moved here from Guatemala.
At first they did only because I wasn't able to express myself, so they would treat me as if I was, like, not slow, but, you know, always just taking their time with me. And I didn't really like that because I wanted to be up to par with everybody else.
Although the region still has a very high crime rate, local schools are working towards having a more inclusive environment for international students.
Culture Diversity Week is a chance for students to share their culture with the community. Laura Black, student life programmer, explains the purpose of having a week like this.
It's about celebrating that we have those cultures, but also acknowledging and breaking down those barriers that are still stopping us from having such an open and honest community with each other.
Things have already started to have a positive effect on the treatment of how people interact.
People is very good and respectful. I really enjoy here and I didn't have any problems.
The region is slowly fixing what was once broken and allowing people of all different backgrounds to feel at home here in Kitchener. For Spoke TV, I'm Lauren Weiler.
Conestoga College President John Tibbetts and Frank Boutis, Chair of the Board of Governors, say changes will be coming to the Polytechnical Institute as it was outlined in this year's strategic plan.
The college has partnered with Wilfrid Laurier University in order to provide more post-secondary options to students in Brantford. A strategic mandate agreement with the Government of Ontario now positions Conestoga to become a provincial leader in college-based degree programming and a preeminent center for engineering, trades, health, and community services. Another notable change is the development of facilities and the construction of a new $18 million recreation and wellness center. Construction for that began September of this year.
18 women in Quebec were recently scarred and burned after attempting to have their tattoos removed by a laser surgery. This has led to widespread concerns about the safety and legitimacy of the procedure. Spoke TV's Katerina Costa brings us more about the controversial practice.
Despite the recent news in Quebec, laser removal is the most popular way of getting an unwanted or old tattoo off your skin. However, laser technicians do not need to hold any licenses or credentials in Canada. Steve Azumi at TD Laser Clinic in Waterloo explains the process of tattoo laser removal.
Usually the clients don't have to prepare anything themselves. I ended up preparing by getting sheets together for consults. So we always do a consult before I'm able to look at the tattoo, assess it, be able to judge how many treatments that it will need, and then be able to go from there and give the client a kind of a breakdown on what we're going to be doing with the procedure and as well as what settings we're going to go through with the machine. There are different types of lasers out there.
Despite its negative reputation, tattoo removal is a safe way to get rid of unwanted or old tattoos. If you are thinking about a tattoo, owner of Lucky Souls Tattoo, Paul Oliver in Cambridge, gives us some tips.
Not so much don'ts, but just pay attention to the portfolios and quality of work and whatnot. It's not so much a don't, but a do. You know, look into what you're getting and maybe think about your idea for a long time, not just go in and pick something, because then you might regret it.
For Spoke TV, I'm Katerina Costa.
Cold temperatures are creeping up on Ontario, but winter isn't the only season quickly approaching. Spoke TV reporter Candice Agunde lets us know how you can reduce your chances of catching a virus as the flu season hits the region.
Cold and flu season is here, and although it may seem like avoiding the winter cold is impossible, there are ways to lessen your chances of getting sick. The flu, or influenza, is a viral infection of the respiratory tract that is considered to be one of the life-threatening infectious diseases. Some signs and symptoms include a fever, sore throat, cough, runny nose, and muscle or body aches. Cindy Ha, a registered practical nurse at Towards Recovery, explains what we can do to prevent the flu.
Would be hand washing. That includes hand sanitizers as well. Another way of preventing the flu is to avoid any direct contact with somebody else who has the flu.
Influenza is highly contagious, and most adults become infectious the day before actual symptoms develop and up to 5 to 7 days after they become sick. So if you do contract the flu, there are certain things you can do to quicken the healing process.
Andra Owensia, a pharmacist at Lang's Pharmacy, says that staying home is the best medicine.
So one should stay at home and get plenty of rest, drink plenty of liquids. One can gargle with a glass of warm salt water or suck on hard lozenges. If one gets stuffy nose, one can use spray or saline drops.
Owensia also suggests consulting with a doctor first before taking any over-the-counter drugs to ensure that they won't interact with any medication that the patient may already be taking. For Spoke TV, I'm Candice Agunde.
Hockey season is here, and aside from practicing your knuckle puck and goal celebrations, preventing a serious head injury is critical. Nearly half of all serious brain injuries among Canadians' kids and teens happens on the hockey rink. So before you step it on the ice, you need to make sure that you have the right helmet.
According to Hockey Canada, there is no concussion-proof helmet, but wearing a properly fitting helmet is the best way to protect yourself from a serious head injury. The first step is establishing the right size. A helmet that is too small or too big will not provide adequate protection. Next, it is important that the helmet has a comfortable fit. Most brands have the ability to adjust a custom fit each individual. The ideal fit is for something that is comfortable with minimal movement on the head. But the most important thing to safety is that all players play with respect to the rules and the safety of others.
It's less than a month until the region is hit with some of the biggest gift-giving celebrations. From Christmas to Hanukkah to Kwanzaa, or if you're just in the mood to spread some holiday joy, Spoke TV reporter Aaron Anderson has you covered with this year's top tech items that are hot for the holidays.
Winter is coming, and that means shorter days, longer nights, and the beginning of the chaos that is holiday shopping. Christmas is just around the corner, and the spirit of gift-giving is in the air. Choosing the perfect gift can be difficult, but Future Shop is shedding some light on what to choose this season. Their recent survey states that 1 in 4 Canadians have tech at the top of their lists. TVs, phones, laptops, and video games are among the hot wish list items that Canadians are asking for. Even though these Kitchener residents have something other than tech in mind, they shared what's at the top of their list for Santa this year.
I want $1 million.
I'd like good health, good fortune, and a good pair of moccasins.
And now for a look at entertainment. Here is Daniela LaRocque.
Thanks, Leah. 7 years after the start of We Day, the world is still showing that helping and caring will never go out of style. Spoke TV reporter Chris Alexander was at We Day taking in some inspiration.
Hold your wings high!
The Kitchener Auditorium was jam-packed Thursday morning for Waterloo Region's 5th annual We Day. Over 7,000 students showed up to take part in the event, which featured recording artists such as Cardinal Official, Sean Desmond, Carl Wolf, and Alyssa Reed, as well as motivational speakers Spencer West, Mustafa the Poet, and Natalie Pinnick.
It may not be the hottest thing to get into, but it's the hardest, as students who come to We Day have to earn their way in by contributing locally or globally to their community. We Day started in 2007 and is still going on strong in 2014. We Day has also raised over $45 million for building schools and wells, amongst other things, in places of need.
We Day is organized by Free the Children, an international charity founded by brothers Craig and Mark Kielburger. Craig, who found Free the Children at age 12, did a press conference and spoke on how seeing poverty and famine at such a young age affected him going forward.
I think that very often in North America, that we think of poverty around the world as a statistic or as one of those Sunday morning commercials. And how it shifted for me on those trips was realizing it was someone I met.
Craig isn't the only young change maker to speak at We Day either. And Alper, an 11-year-old blogger and youth activist, shared why she believes in making a difference.
My motto is that little things add up to make a huge difference. And from my passion with the environment, I have so many other passions, such as poverty and child labor and hunger and clean water and education. Education is a big one for me.
For more information on Free the Children or to donate, you can visit their website at freethechildren.com. For Spoke TV, I'm Chris Alexander.
There is now a new way of sending money through an already popular app. Snap Cash claims to be fast and easy.
Credit cards and debit cards may be a thing of the past as technology is once again taking another step ahead. After the release of Apple Pay, Snapchat has decided to jump on the bandwagon of mobile banking. On November 17th, Snapchat released a music video describing its latest update called Snap Cash. With Snap Cash, people can send money on their phone by typing in the amount they wish to send to a friend. After putting in your credit card information, your friend will receive a notification. Currently, Snap Cash is only available in the United States.
Abracadabra, magic will never be a disappearing act with students connecting their magical skills through Conestoga's Magic Club. Spoke TV reporter Marion De Palma is sharing some insights into the world of magic.
Some people may think that magic is a very questionable area of the performing arts. When you think of the word magician, generally, thoughts come to mind of people like Chris Angel or Harry Houdini, but not in this case. Okay, Kitchener-Waterloo is home to a few tricksters of its own. one of which walks the halls of Conestoga College every day. Spoke TV sat down with second-year broadcast television student Joseph Peplinski, or JP Magic as he prefers, to see why he thinks some people are so interested in magic.
And I think people want to be fooled, you know? People want to be, like, amazed by the sleight of hand or a simple entertainer joke.
The first book of magic tricks dates back to 1584, but there are more ways than by just reading a book that hopeful magicians can use to learn this form of art in 2014. One spectator and magic enthusiast, Jordan Smith, says one way he observes magic and why it's so interesting to him.
I like watching YouTube videos of magic tricks. I mean, I don't like go to many like actual magic shows or anything. But yeah, I love being fooled. I think that's like the craziest part about it, is they do something and you think you know what they're doing, and then at the end, it's just not what you expected.
Anyone interested in the art of magic in the Kitchener area can even visit Kind of Magic, the local magic and costume shop uptown Waterloo, where you can find anything from card tricks to spooky props. For Spoke TV, I'm Marian DePalma.
Thanks for watching Spoke TV. I'm Jeff Pickle.
And I'm Leah Johansson. For more news and information, visit us online at spoketv.ca or follow us on Twitter.